back on Jatun Road. It's early in the morning. The town has just sort of waking up, and we're here for Rocky's favorite breakfast.
What better thing to eat first thing in the morning than royal utter chicken, deep-fried fish, and lots of meats?
I can think of at least 357,000 things that I would rather eat than that, but this is about the non-vegetarian speciality breakfast here.
Ding!
Good morning, Uncle. Ah! We're standing with our friends, Mr. Kawaljeet Singh Sethi and his sons, I've forgotten, but also known as Rinku, Sonu and Lovely. But the smell coming out of that food is incredible.
Yes, by the time we're done with this, Kawaljeet Singh is going to have another son who's going to want to stay on here, and he's going to be called happy.
What's lovely over here, there are two standard items on the menu. One is, of course, the famous Atta Chicken that we're going to show you in a while. And the other one is this wonderful fried fish. Now, it's a little different from most fish, like the Amritsari fish, in the sense that it's not marinated. This is just put into the spice over here, taken out and put in. And what it's called is desi fish.
I don't know about the fish, but the recipe for the atta, royal atta chicken, actually came when Kawaljeet Singh Ji moved here from the town of Otwar, where they lived on the border of Afghanistan and Pakistan.
The way to cook the chicken comes from the Bukka sheep, which is a sheep which has a whole lot of extra fat and meat, and is really conducive to the style of cooking. Now, it's not called dum in Afghanistan. We haven't been able to get our finger on what it's called, really. But what we do know is that it has to be completely sealed and then cooked for about 3 hours, and that's the chicken. If we go back to the sheep, I can't even imagine how long that's going to take. But the fish is smelling really good. And what can be better than this? Now, that is an exceptional fish. Even though it's been deep-fried, floating in oil, it's absolutely dry on top, and it's done perfectly on the inside. No bones again, because it's a Singhara fish. It's these nice, big chunks of fish, and they are delightfully done. The batter is so light, and it sticks on in this amazing way. I have to try and figure out how this works.
Here comes the chicken.
Wow. Happy meets Murgi.
What that looks like is a ham, but inside it is a delicious chicken. This is the finished product. It's almost done. All that needs to be done to that now is that it has to be heated, so it's going back into the tandoor or the patti. And once it's heated, we're ready to eat it.
But it's also important to note that it takes 3 hours for this whole chicken from the time it starts to get out there before you can dig your teeth into it. 3 full hours on this procedure. And between 10 o'clock and 6 o'clock is the only time you can come in and order a chicken with that lead time of 3 hours. If you come in past 6 o'clock, there's no way you're going to get chicken unless somebody cancels or decides to turn vegetarian.
In the winter, you can actually take that completely baked product and ship it out as it is, and apparently it stays for 15 days. 15 din to sikhe. Up to 15 days in the fridge. But if you take it out like this, 2 or 3 days, you can transport it anywhere over the country. And you pop it open, and a fresh, delicious chicken awaits the eating. How do they make it? What do they put in it? How is it prepared? What's the final product? Unfortunately, we can't tell you any of those things because this is a top secret recipe. So all they've agreed to do is show us what they're going to put into the fire and show us the finished product, and nothing in between, though we know the secret now.
We're not about to share.
So here we go. The final product is about to come in front of our eyes. That entire bake is going to be broken open. That's how it's crushed. And now the dough is being taken off, and inside the dough is a beautifully muslin cloth wrapped secret recipe ingredient, top secret, juicy. Oh my God, look at that juice coming out of it. So here's how the game begins. The chicken is marinated, kept for a few hours, wrapped with a muslin cloth, dough is wrapped around it. It's shoved into a really hot oven to cook. Takes a really long time, a total of about 3 hours to start from the preparation to the cooking stage. And here's the finished product. Goes all the way to Bombay. In shorter ranges, it goes to Chandigarh and Patenda. In fact, when we were here in the morning, there were 4 chickens freshly done, being packed off and sent to Chandigarh, which is a little way away. Now, here's the 2 or 3 wonderful things about this chicken. Number one, it is very well done without being burnt on the outside.
But
it is extremely tender, extremely juicy. In fact, the juice just gets trapped in and soaks right through. What's happened to the flavor also is probably because of the dough outside. This pressure has squeezed the spices all the way through. So you take a piece anywhere and you can actually see on the inside the spices that have soaked through. Take a look at that. They go right into the chicken with the pressure.
Trapped in there was a surprise. There's something for the vegetarian section too. There's almonds here. What I would like to add here though is small towns are not just about chickens and people that come to eat them. It's also about people with a wonderful mentality as hosts. These people standing here, even though it's a speciality chicken shop, are feeling really bad that I'm not eating. So there you go, the almonds. They, in fact, even wanted to send out for some paneer because they heard me talking about it, because they felt bad that someone's come to their place.
Excuse me.
Something we people in the big cities can learn from instead of just jostling and pushing for our food.
The good news for all you chicken fans out there is that Mr. Kanwarjeet Singh is opening a big restaurant over here where they're going to be serving the Royal Atta Chicken. The other good news is we'll call it the Freedom Royal Atta Chicken because Mr. Kanwarjeet Singh's birthday is on 15th August 1947. Jai Hind.
आपको आजाद सिंह नाम रखना चाहिए था माँ बाप ने।